is abuzz at the home of the Yellow Jackets. ACC basketball today. Number one Duke comes to Atlanta to take on the 10th-ranked Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. I'm Jim Nance, and welcome to Duke against Georgia Tech. Well, the two-time national champion Blue Devils have won 23 straight games. Today, they're going for the all-time school record with a victory today, giving them number 24. And in fact, Duke is one of only three unbeatens in Division 1A basketball, because just this week, five fell from the ranks of the unbeaten. Iowa, Purdue, Kentucky, you saw the list, they all lost. And now the three that are still there unbeaten, Duke, number two, Kentucky, and the third team, also out of the ACC, a surprise to some, Virginia, unbeaten at 9-0. My partner, as always, is Billy Packer. And Billy, let's talk about Duke. We last saw them at the Metrodome winning the national championship against Michigan. How does this team stack up with last year's edition?
Well, Jim, I don't think this team is as good as last year's basketball team, but I don't think anybody in college basketball probably as good as that club. Mike would be the first to admit that, but it is an outstanding basketball team capable of beating anybody in the country. We see right here the Dukes of scoring. There's the threesome we're all so familiar with, the two Hills and Hurley. They really represent 57% of this year's scoring on this ball club.
Well, they call them the 3H company, the two Hills and Hurley. But how about Georgia Tech and their scoring?
Well, they have an excellent basketball team as well. James Forrest is leading the ACC in scoring right now. Last year, as a freshman, he came in a little overweight. But you can see the man that beat him out for freshman of the year, Bob Sura, right under him. Forrest off to an excellent start this season.
You love the basketball style that Duke will play when they have possession. Let's talk about some of the devil options when they have it.
Well, one of the things we usually see is Bobby Hurley, the leader, but on the court right now is not a Bobby Hurley. We see Thomas Hill going to hit Grant Hill on the wing. And now there's going to be that solid screen from the backside, allowing Grant Hill to throw the lob to Thomas Hill. But Oklahoma does a good job defensively, and they cut this particular option off. You can see the pass goes out to Grant. There's a solid screen. Nothing doing for Thomas Hill. Duke wisely rotates the ball back again. Thomas Hill gets ready to set up in the low post for the second option on this particular play. The ball is swung around. Watch how well Hill operates on the baseline as he gets the pass down low and hits that patented turnaround jumper of his. Excellent play by the veteran Duke club.
Well, good matchup at the point today. You got Bobby Hurley against Travis Best. Let's talk about Best.
Well, Best, of course, one of the premier guards in the country coming out of high school 2 years ago. Normally, he's the guy that's handling the ball for Georgia Tech. But in this particular case, we can see Forrest in the low post. They can't hit him down low. Best moves away on this particular play, looking to get a solid screen from Mackey. The ball is swung back over, and watch how nicely Best gets off. A beautiful jump shot from the wings. An excellent backcourt play.
Can Georgia Tech stop Duke today?
I think they can. This crowd is going to have a lot to do with it.
It's a wild crowd, a great scene. We have number one Duke on the road taking on Georgia Tech, and it's coming up next.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Sinex, the only decongestant spray with Vicks Vapors for sinus, think Sinex. And by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Memorial Coliseum, as Mike Krzyzewski, a win today will tie him with Norm Sloan for sixth all-time in ACC victories. Here's his starting lineup. Grant Hill, Cherokee Parks, and Antonio Lang returns to the starting lineup. He had been injured and had not started the past three. Hurley and Thomas Hill in the backcourt. Bobby Crimmins of Georgia Tech, an outstanding record here at home. He's won 122 times, only 21 losses here in the Thriller Dome, as they call it. Mackey, Newbill, and Forrest. That's a good size front court. Back court, Travis Best, and Brian Hill will start for Martise Moore, who's been out a couple of games with the flu. We expect to see Moore today, however. The ACC officiating crew, Lenny Wirtz from Mount Healthy, Ohio, Larry Rose from Portland, Virginia, and Stan Rote from Abingdon, Maryland. Parks and Newbill. And it belongs to Bobby Hurley and the Devils.
Straight man-to-man, Jim. I expect to see some zone out of Georgia Tech early in this one.
Grant Hill, one bounce and the jumper. Long rebound to Travis Best.
big overplay, and there's that matchup. Grant Hill down on the inside with Forrest. Could be a situation that either one of those get into foul trouble, and it really will take the balance and change it in this game.
Parks defending on Newbill, who doesn't have a lot of offensive skills, but he's going to try a shot right away, and he nails it.
If anybody has been disappointing to Bobby Crimmins so far this year, it's been Newbill. Former Georgia High School Player of the Year, but he has not scored well. That's a big indication that Georgia Tech will go down inside to him.
Billy's averaging only 4 points a game, and he gets the game's first bucket. Lang has it stripped away. A good steal by Best.
He's to give it. Boy, he had Hill in a perfect position to give it up and went all the way himself.
Foul against Thomas Hill.
Foul on Thomas Hill. That's his first. Team first.
Brian Hill to inbound. Three Hills on the court.
Brian, of course, in those two starts, has played extremely well. 20 points in those two games.
That's a two by Travis Best. First 4 points for Georgia Tech. Two by Newbill. By Best.
Oh, beautiful feed.
Hill dished it off to Parks. He couldn't handle it. And Brian Hill comes out with it.
Well, Mackey was part of the Georgia Tech group that beat Duke in the semifinals of the ACC a couple of years ago. He said, whatever team wants it more. So far, Jim, it looks like that's Georgia Tech.
Grant Hill gets the rebound off to Forrest. Misfire. Three-pointer by Hurley. Too strong. But he follows it up and gives it up to Parks.
That's
indeed, traveling on Cherokee Parks.
Duke picking up full court. 2-2-1, full court zone press. Thomas Hill, an excellent defender up there to stop the ball penetration. Forrest was wide open for the shot.
Travis Best, three is in and out. And Mackey gets the loose change. Oh! Forrest. 6-0 Georgia Tech.
Jim, this is a very physical and tall front line. And as we know, Duke considerably smaller without Christian Laettner on that floor.
Baseline jumper. Tie-up situation. The arrow belongs to the Yellow Jackets, who have shut out Duke in the first 2.5 minutes.
Again, Duke wanting to pick up early with Hurley. Trying to put some pressure on Best. Best certainly up to that task. That man is strong, good ball handler. We saw that he's got the excellent outside shot. Good pump fake by Newbill.
And Newbill was fouled in the act of shooting by Lang. So put him on the line.
Jim, you talked about Newbill. He's only averaging up to this point, not only 4 points a game is he averaging, but only taking three shots a game. Now here he has touched the ball twice in this game, both times making good offensive moves to the basket. Once a score and once putting himself on the foul line.
Under 50% from the line, 47% free throw shooter. But good on the first.
You know, and in fairness to Newbill, the two knee operations that he had since last season really took an awful lot out of his opportunity to prepare for this season. So he's probably just starting to round into shape now.
Showed great promise as a freshman. Had 19 rebounds in a game as a freshman, but now a junior. And a whistle here, Billy, by...
Now, two men, I really thought that should have canceled itself out because Mackey, Grant Hill were both in the lane at the same time. I think they were all in there. Let's see what he's going to call. And it's going to be Duke ball. Yep.
Double lane violation.
Yep. Double violation, and the arrow belongs to the Devils.
Nice piece of officiating there. Unlike international basketball, where the team shooting can go on in there early.
They won the last five in the matchup.
This match here, and you've got Mackey on Hurley.
Forrest saw it. He tips it over to Newbill.
I'm really surprised Bobby Hurley didn't put the ball on the floor and beat Mackey that time.
Jumper, Forrest, 9-0. Duke is 0 for 3 from the floor and 4 turnovers.
Thomasville double team.
Offensive.
Great defense that time by Hill.
Second foul on Thomas Hill.
Brian Hill was a starter in 28 games in 91, primarily as a defender. That was his role coming off the bench last year. And you could see he did an excellent job on Thomas Hill.
Basket three-pointer. 21 straight games he's made a three.
Mike Krzyzewski said you can't let Travis Best get on a roll from the outside. So far he is.
12 to nothing. This game almost 4 minutes old.
Duke goes to their 1-4 offense.
Hurley. At last, Duke on the board with a three.
Jim, that just adds to the number of games Bobby Hurley has hit a key three-point shot to get his team on track. Oklahoma last week. Vegas a couple of years ago. Kentucky. The list goes on and on.
The 6-7 they hit against Indiana in the semis last year. Hugo tried a little soft baby hook. And the rebound goes to Thomas Hill. Hurley pushes it up. Grant short. Rebound by Forrest.
James Forrest is a man. I mean,
only
his
a sophomore. Here's another one. Mackey inside.
Now Bobby Crimmins told us that he wondered if his team had enough confidence to play against Duke. It's obvious they do.
Travis Best averaging 5 assists a game. You saw him. He gets credit for that assist to Mackey. Hurley, good dish to Parks. Gonna call it on Newbill.
Jim, I really thought Cherokee Parks should have been in a position to be moving as he caught that ball, and his hesitation almost cost him another walk.
Thomas Hill, Antonio Lang will sit. Again, here are the teams that lost already this week. Iowa, Purdue, UNLV, Clemson, Xavier for the first time, leaving only the three unbeaten. So Marty Clark has come in. He's number 3 for Duke. And also Eric Meek, number 52. Clark hits the first.
Nothing new for this Duke team. They've scored 107 more points than their opponents from the foul line this year. And actually have made 49 more than the opponents have shot. So that's something that's a tradition with them.
Parks nails them both. 15-12 remaining first half. An officials timeout checked by 9.
Happens on the screen for Hurley. Hurley gets lost. Best steps out. Reverse pass. Best gets his three-point shot off. Bobby Hurley has got to fight over the top on this particular play. He's nowhere to be seen as Travis Best, who had some bad games last year against Duke, is off to a good start today.
14-5, Georgia Tech. In the top 10 this week for the first time since the final poll of 1990, when that Lethal Weapon 3 squad went to the Final Four. That's the last time they were in the top 10 before this week. Hill driving past Clark, swatted away by Parks.
Great offensive rebounding.
Malcolm Mackey.
Had 17 boards in his last game against Maryland.
And that rebound, Billy, that he put back up was his career 1,000th rebound. Three-pointer pull-up by Best. Holy smokes, 14-point lead for Georgia Tech.
Jimmy had 81 in a high school game. Mike Krzyzewski was really worried about stopping him at three. Bobby Hurley has not been able to get out on him.
Brad Hill off balance, but he got it.
Jimmy, he looked to the pass twice on each side of the lane on that play before he released it for the shot. James Forrest got a smile on his face down there with Grant Hill on his back. Not a good pass.
Hill touched it.
Now, if you're Bobby Crimmins, you don't want Newbill out on the top handling the ball, but he just got caught out there. Bobby Hurley looking for screens behind him. So far, he's been lost in the pack against Travis Best.
Forrest way off on that one.
Meek got a piece of it.
Hurley with the pass ahead to Grant Hill. Slapped on the way up. He'll shoot two.
Good hesitation by Grant Hill on that play.
When you look at his stats this year, Jim, I mean, all the way across the board. Shooting 64%. Still hasn't made a three-point shot this year. It's really amazing. In his career, he's made one.
One against Arizona his freshman year. Hasn't attempted many. Last year, only attempted three.
Right.
Subs in for Georgia Tech. Drew Berry, number 10, has come in, along with Martise Moore, number 23.
And everything else about this young man, 20 block shots, 25 steals, averaging 19.9 a game, 6.4 rebounds, complete player.
28 against Canisius in the season opener, where he had six dunks. 27 against BYU in the final of the Maui Invitational. Duke back within 10. 19-9, Yellow Jackets.
Georgia Tech gets a little bit smaller here, but their perimeter game is excellent because Moore can shoot out there. Berry's a good ball handler, and that frees up Best some.
Berry. Last touch, Moore. It belongs to Duke. And that's the first turnover committed by Georgia Tech.
Berry's got to calm down just a little bit, Jim, trying to make plays that aren't quite there coming in off the bench, particularly with this kind of lead.
Hill on the baseline, kiss off the glass.
You know what he does, Jim? He goes up for shots, and then he has that extra lift. And that time, he just let the defender get out of the way and just went up a little higher.
Both of his shots that have dropped from the floor, he's been suspended in air. And a five count against Best without penetrating. Turn it over for the second time by the Yellow Jackets.
Now, Travis has to think a little bit on that play. Bobby Hurley, probably as good as anybody, playing head up on the dribbler. Travis has been very effective using going without the ball and getting down in the pack and then popping out. He doesn't want to challenge Hurley that way.
They set it up. Oh! Hill almost tipped it, and he got it back.
Mackey a little annoyed that somebody would try to throw a lob over him. You see Bobby Hurley putting that lob up. Mackey did the right thing, blocking out Grant Hill, and then got annoyed, said, I'm going to smack that one away.
Forrest was called for his first foul, and Lang is in for Parks.
Two shots, guys.
Two shots for Grant Hill. Most of you know he was on the U.S. select team over the summer, and Billy, he talks openly about how much confidence he gained off that experience, and I really never had as much confidence as you might think. I really never knew or thought that I was a real good player. And he comes away now after that experience feeling much better about himself.
Well, you know, I think, and this is true with the Duke system, I think when a freshman comes in, he lets the seniors take over those roles of leadership. And now in this particular game, you see him moving to the front. Here again, Best working Hurley with the dribble. See if he starts going down and behind some screens. Here he comes. Hurley much more aware of him now.
Forrest jumper. And Berry fights for it over Meek. They call Meek for the foul.
Jim, this is kind of surprising about Duke. This is the first game they've played this year on an opponent's real home court. You know, they played on the road, but not in somebody's home arena.
Duke on an 8-0 run. Mackey posts up Meek. Malcolm Mackey with six.
And here's a young man that has really developed throughout his career and wisely stayed in college. I mean, you know, he's now going to become a real factor as an NBA player. Had he come out early, I don't think that would have been the case. And when you think of Georgia Tech, you know, a guy that came out early would still be a senior here, Kenny Anderson. That would be some backcourt, he and Travis Best.
I still think Kenny Anderson came out a year too soon.
I would agree. And he probably would too, but with everything, with the exception of his bank account.
Foul was against Travis Best, his first. Hurley will shoot two. Here's what you were talking about, Billy, earlier. From the free throw line, they have made, as you can see, almost 50 more than their opponents have attempted.
And Jim, we talked yesterday to Mike Krzyzewski about that and the philosophy of going to the line and going inside a lot. And last week we talked to Rick Pitino about his philosophy on the outside three-point game. So completely different philosophies as to how to play it offensively.
Mackey put it on the floor and drove, and Berry cut to the basket off the pass. A turnover, number three against Tech, but they still lead by seven.
There's the zone defense. We knew this was coming. Good screen.
Long rebound to Berry.
Great defense by Bobby Hurley.
Forrest over Hill.
Now James Forrest, one of those unusual players, Jim, that has great leaping ability and tremendous physique and then still has the soft jump shot.
Top scorer in the ACC has six. Georgia Tech leads number one Duke by nine. Final four visits the last 7 years. Duke six times, including five straight. Kansas and UNLV with three. Georgia Tech was at the Final Four in 1990. We'll look at the Blue Devils. Thomas Hill sitting, a starter, second leading scorer for the Blue Devils. And in fact, he won a game here on a last second shot 2 years ago.
Yes, he did. They're a little concerned. Back to the zone now. Let's see a little bit of a matchup. It looks like it's going to be a prime. With a diamond and one on Hurley.
Hart's way short on the 10-footer.
Bobby Crimmins mixing up the defenses. Showed a man-to-man, showed a straight zone, and that time, a diamond and one.
Yes, with a nice move to free himself. He has 10 points, and it's Tech by 11.
In the last seven games, the kid has scored 118 points, 39 assists, and only 15 turnovers.
Marty Clark in the lane with the scoop shot. He'd been starting for Antonio Lang the last three games.
He's moved to the backcourt in this particular game. Pretty versatile wing player.
Drew Berry.
Some rebound there.
Mackey goes to the other side and rejected by Hill. Parks blocks that one. Now Forrest.
And this team is a great offensive rebounding team because they've got not only height, but they've got power. Let's see this defense right now. Now, you can see Berry is on Hurley, so it is. It's a box or diamond and one.
Foul outside, called against Moore.
Here's a great block by Grant Hill on Mackey. Mackey puts it back up, but nobody puts a body on Forrest, who comes right back down and through the pack and scores.
Thomas Hill returns.
Now this defense won't be as effective with Hill in there for Lang, because now you got another wing player that can shoot. Thomas Hill should be able to get a jump shot against this defense.
Halfway through the first half, and Thomas Hill fires the three short.
Mackey so clever with that rebound. Thomas Hill a little anxious. He can get that jump shot.
Alley-oop to Forrest. And Grant Hill gets the long rebound to the other side. Hurley speeds it up court.
Blocked.
Had it blocked by Moore. Belongs to Duke.
We're seeing some real athleticism out here. Super pass by Hurley. Thomas Hill, who we know can finish. But Moore, the freshman who has been idled by the flu and a little problem with his ankle, really got up in the air on that one.
Hurley gets the pass over to Grant Hill. And he is chopped on the hand by Mackey. His first, team foul number six.
And Jim, we talk about Duke going to the foul line so much, and as we saw in the two games we've had with Indiana this year, another team that goes to the foul line a lot. They shot poorly from the line against Kansas, and then last week against Kentucky, the same thing cost them two games. Duke in that Oklahoma game missed 11 straight free throws at one point in the game, which is hard to believe from this club.
And led then, of course, to under 50% for the game, a rarity for Duke.
And they were 15 for 31 in that ball game.
9 points for Grant Hill. He's 5 for 5 from the line. Now have a player from his same high school up in Virginia. South Lakes High School joining Duke next year, Joey Beard, 6'10 recruit. And Lang comes back to give Hill a breather. Grant Hill, that is.
And let's see if Bobby Crimmins stays now in that box or diamond in one. And that's going to force Marty Clark to play with Hill on the wing, potentially to get an outside shot, because Lang certainly won't take one out there.
Moore, their top recruit this year, gives it up to Brian Hill. Drives in. Contact with Lang, but no call. Hill with his first two.
Just like as a high school running back that he was, he put his shoulder down and turned the corner. There it is. They're staying with it.
Parks, whoa, that one almost got away from him.
Basic 2-3 zone now, not box and one. Matching up out of it. They were really extended on that matchup. Moore, who's playing down in the backside, ended up in the top. Good job.
Moore read it. They gave it up to Parks. He tried to give it right back, and Moore got the steal. Best. Traveling.
Travis Best probably, Jim, took it in a couple of dribbles too much. You know, if you're going to get inside with a dribble like that as a small guy, you've got to have the direct pass to the shot. You get in there, you get up in the air, and there's nothing you can do with the ball. Now let's check this defense out again. Matching up out of it. Hurley gets fouled.
That'll be three. He was fouled in the act of shooting. He'll shoot three free throws.
You talk about the University of Virginia still undefeated the other night. Bob Sura had a shot from the wing, got fouled outside the three-point line, had a chance to go and pull that game out, was not able to hit them. Virginia stayed undefeated.
Second against Best. Hurley on track to set the all-time NCAA record for assists held by Chris Corciani. He already has the NCAA tournament record.
And obviously the Duke record. And also the Duke three-point shot record. And they had to take Travis Best out. One of the things that has really hampered his play this year, and he's had an outstanding season, is getting into foul trouble.
And one more. Bobby, the MOP, not the MVP of the Final Four. They call it most outstanding player. And he only gets one out of three.
And he was the MVP of the Maui Classic. And here's going to be a matchup. Barry's got to give this ball up. He doesn't want to challenge Hurley.
What a quick move to the basket by Forrest. Now with eight. Thomas Hill pulls up. Yep.
Boy, is Moore getting up on the boards. Jim, an excellent defensive play on the last sequence and then way up on the boards.
Tech scored the game's first 12 points.
Young man from Atlanta, but attended Oak Hill Academy.
Talking about Martise Moore. Oh. 12-point lead. There he is, Moore. Parks blocked out. Barry almost got the steal.
Good hustle.
Under the 8-minute mark in the first half, an official's timeout. Well, there's your game summary. You see field goal percentage? Duke has attempted 14 shots, 4 out of 14. Tech has made as many from the floor as Duke has attempted. They're 14 out of 28.
And Jim, we're talking about a Duke team that on the year is shooting 55% from the floor. But we're also talking about a Tech team that has not had anybody shoot over 50% against them yet this year. Matter of fact, they held they've held a couple of teams down below 30.
Yeah, they held
like the old Georgetown days.
VMI had 26%.
Right. Now VMI is not Duke, but that's still shutting a man down. They held Virginia down under 30% last year in the ACC tournament. So it's a big club. You don't get many second shots. A lot of power in there.
Thomas Hill. Oh. rebound by Forrest. Travis Best is still on the bench.
I think Bobby Kermans wants to make sure he doesn't pick up that third foul here in this first half. Kept handling the ball well as a team. Guys making good catches out here. Everybody gives an ooh and an ah, so Newville gets back under the basket. They don't want him as their point guard.
Brian Hill notices the shot clock. And good D up by Thomas Hill. Got a tie-up situation out of it, and the arrow belongs to Georgia Tech, a new 45.
That brought Mike Krzyzewski off the bench, wanting to work the refs a little bit.
Thomas Hill has a chance to be the National Defensive Player of the Year.
What, the third one that Duke has had to win the Coach Ibo Award?
They had Billy King.
Tommy Amaker.
Tommy Amaker, who sits on the Duke bench as an assistant.
He came to Stacy Ogden Award there for a couple of years. The young man now playing in Atlanta in the pro ranks.
Barry, he'll take the three.
Beautiful. Yep.
And just like his father, beautiful rotation on that long-range jumper.
Yeah, that was great ball handling by Georgia Tech. Moore and Forrest hitting the open man on a reversal.
Largest lead for the Yellow Jackets, 15. Hill fouled on the move to the basket. Second foul against Moore.
Well, Jim, we remember the great Johnny Dawkins clubs that went to the Final Four, lost in the final game back in 86. They came in here ranked two in the nation. Georgia Tech beat them that year, 87-80. They have beaten actually two teams that are defending national champions on this floor the next year. Villanova, they knocked them off after Raleigh Massimino's club had, had won. And then they beat NC State after State had won under Jimmy Valvano.
Mackey in for Moore. They could add to that total today.
Exactly.
That team in 86 with Dawkins lost only three games. And this was the second of their three losses that year. Talked about Tommy Amaker, Duke assistant. He's going to be an outstanding head coach someday, somewhere.
One of the best dressed assistant coaches in America, don't you think? Always looks sharp over there. Works hard in practice.
One of my favorite players ever in college basketball. Now Barry, ahead on the break.
Looked like Barry got hurt a little bit, got hit in the throat. But again, dribbled a little bit too far. If you don't have the immediate play, it's best to pull that ball up at the foul line area.
So that's the first on Barry.
See, again, no play to be made, and dribbles about two dribbles too many, and doesn't have the angle for the dish. Picks up the charge.
So a 1-1 for Grant Hill.
Grant Hill at the line shooting 1-1.
Tech Billy has attempted only one free throw. This will be Duke's 16th.
Oh, a little young man gets out on the floor.
And he's a Tech fan. That's six men on the court. Should that be a technical?
Well, San Antonio still, what was it, San Antonio the other day? Was it
against Phoenix?
Yeah. I can't, on that particular level of play, I cannot understand the officials not having a technical foul there.
That's the last time, Dad is saying, it's the last time I buy a courtside seat.
Well, and let's hope that Mom doesn't think Dad's out is at home babysitting him. would that be an out-of-the-bag deal? Duke picking up full court with Travis Best out there thinking they can take advantage of ball handling.
Grant Hill has 14 of Duke's 23.
They really don't have a primary ball handler with Barry and Best both out of the game.
And Hill got a hand on it to save what would have been a sure layup by Forrest. Near the conclusion of this game, we'll be selecting a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. Chevrolet donates a $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of each school. A steal by Grant Hill.
Good hit ahead.
Hurley gets the trailer. over the back, Newbill.
They just don't give you any easy baskets. I think Bobby Crimmins ought to get Barry back into the game in a hurry, Jim, because he doesn't have a primary ball handler on the floor, and Duke will take advantage of that. I'm going to ask Brian Hill to do most. Here comes Barry back in. Smart move by Bobby.
And a good call by Packer. Newbill with his second. Thomas Hill will shoot two.
Well, you know, you get in a situation where you're controlling the game pretty well. You want to use a little bit of the clock. You're not going to have Best back in the game because you don't want any more foul trouble there. And Duke can turn you over, as we've seen over the years, in a hurry on the defensive end of the floor.
Hill gets his first point. He's 0 for 4 from the floor. Moore on the left. Newbill was on the right. Song. Now Thomas Hill, he had 25 over in Hawaii against LSU, averaging 17 a game.
And this pressure defense is forcing.
Good bounce pass. Wow, what an assist by Barry.
It's forcing Georgia Tech to continue to play an up-tempo game. Excellent pass and a really good angle on that play. Crimmins wanted a walk on that play. Back into that matchup zone. Good help.
Try to give it up to Parks. The hand got in there. Ahead to Brian Hill. Slam dunk.
Jim, Moore has made some of the smartest defensive plays that I have seen for a freshman in a long time. Being in the right place at the right time, he's really thinking out there.
Sticking a hand in, forcing a steal. He's done it on several occasions. Thomas Hill with a three. Off of Lang.
Here we talk about the angle on a pass. There's that long lob. Nobody back for defensive balance for Duke. And Hill breaks long.
Eric Meek in. Marty Clark will also re-enter.
Well, Jim, Duke got it down under 10 points. Obviously, what you want to do on the road here with the first half drawing a little bit to a close. There's a bomb.
Tipped over to Barry.
Oh,
back
yes.
to Forrest. What a near attempt for an assist by Barry.
Well, the all-time assist leader for Georgia Tech. Barry reminds me an awful lot of him. He's got Noodle's physique. He sees ahead. He's quick.
Clark with the steal for Duke. Hurley off the screen.
That's saying an awful lot for this early in his career, but he reminds me a lot of Noodle's Craig Neal that played here a few years ago.
Mackey with position.
Another smart play by Moore.
Mackey has 8 points, and with now 5 rebounds, he's moved past Gene Banks, 20th all-time in the ACC. A three by Clark.
There's Duke just setting up before Georgia Tech could get their defense set.
And an official's timeout, under 4 minutes. The lead is at 10 for number 10, Georgia Tech. Well, coming up on Prudential Securities at the half, Greg Gumbel will get you caught up on the latest sports news, highlights of that Dallas Cowboys victory today, plus a look at the inspirational return of Notre Dame forward Monty Williams. That's all coming up at the half. 40-30, Georgia Tech, 3:58 before halftime.
Jimmy, you can see Duke setting up to try to stop that home run bomb that Georgia Tech used twice against them. And they deploy a nice little system, step a man out of bounds to eliminate the defensive pressure.
Playing the second half of this opening half without Travis Best, saddled with 2 fouls.
Barry has done a nice job with the ball, as has Moore. Everybody kind of happy to see Georgia Tech potentially get on the foul line.
Meek with his second. 5 against Duke, so that not in a 1-on-1.
That was before any shot.
Oh.
See, what Moore's doing is throwing right over the top of Duke. You know, he's listed at, what, 6'7", and he plays bigger than 6'7".
Billy, in the paint points, 20-2 for Georgia Tech.
Well, any points other than on the foul line for Duke have been hard to come by. There's that turnaround jumper by Mackey. 6'10", 245 with a soft touch. Back to the zone. Thomas Hill, Clark, and Hurley all capable of hitting the three against this zone, but they've got to get some cutters to get free on the baseline. There it is.
Thomas Hill.
Jim, a little bit of movement, a little ball penetration with the dribble creates, when you've got three fellas that can play on the perimeter as Duke has right now, it'll create that shot.
He'll rip that one for his first points from the floor. He has five overall. And he got a hand in there on Brian Hill.
Well, is Brian strong? I mean, Thomas has built his body up considerably from the time we first saw him as a freshman. But he saw a forearm shiver there and almost put him over backwards.
Talking about Brian Hill, you said something earlier about made a football comparison. He in high school was his team's leading rusher and scorer in football. Originally signed with Maryland. And pass off the fingertips of Forrest.
Well, again, I think that the key for Georgia Tech here, and Hill is saying to all his players, move, but really the key, I think, is to keep the ball in the hands of Berry and Moore. Even though they're rookies out here, they've been doing a good job distributing with best absence, in best absence. Is that matchup zone again?
Forrest, strong rebound.
Moore got to Hurley just in time. Nice help.
Moore threw that one away to Meek. And in traffic, Forrest reached in on Hurley. His second. 16 free throws versus only one for Georgia Tech. But look at the edge in field goals.
19-7. Did you notice, Jim, on that particular play, one of the reasons we talk about how Bobby Hurley can push the ball up the floor so well, he can go with either hand at equal speed. And when he has a guy beat or semi-beat, he turns that shoulder in and gains the advantage. And even though Forrest is a very powerful young man, Bobby Hurley, with that speed and quickness and that shoulder turn, was able to get ahead of him and draw the foul.
They'll shoot one more. They're in the double bonus. Kenny Blakeney, number four, has come in for Duke. For five from the line.
Oh, and Berry challenging him with the dribble. You know, Berry has got to understand, when you're playing against the Hurley, don't challenge him. Give the ball up. Let somebody else fight him the length of the court. Then get it back when you can operate on a half a court situation. And try him again. There's a screen. Oh,
what a
wow.
And they call Mackey on it.
Now, Bobby Hurley is maybe as tough as anybody I've ever seen play college basketball. But he took a blow there that will knock you out. And he's not getting up off the floor. This is really a brutal screen. Wow. And you know what? I don't think it was a foul.
There was a little bit of a push by Mackey.
I'll tell you, for Bobby to sit down on the floor, and remember last year, he did not play here at Georgia Tech. They played without him. He really is hurting here. This is the toughest kid I think I've ever seen in college basketball, and you really have to hit him to put him down like that.
Took the wind right out of him is what they did.
And you know whose fault it really is, and not to point out faults, but is in the case of the man that is guarding Mackey, the man guarding Mackey, and you'll see a little bit extra after the hit, though. I really, you know, it's almost a legitimate, solid screen.
And Mackey in a...
Well, how tough
class gesture comes over and slaps Bobby from behind and says, hey, sorry about that.
Now, if you're Mike Krzyzewski, I'd put a different guy on the line to shoot this foul shot. You know Hurley's got to be woozy here. He's 2 out of 5. He can pick anybody. I'd take Bobby Hurley out of the game and let somebody else shoot it for him. Let's see what they're going to do.
They're going to take him out.
Yeah, it's a smart move here. You know he's got to be groggy.
he has to come out to prevent a timeout.
Right.
And Thomas Hill will shoot the free throws. Double bonus situation. He'll shoot two.
Could pick anybody on that bench, put him on in there to shoot it.
Do you remember the game last year, the regular season game we had up at Michigan, and Hurley was in the same situation, got injured, and had to shoot the free throws?
Right.
Three of them. He was fouled shooting at three, and he made all three of them, helping send the game to overtime and a later Duke victory.
Well, you have to almost knock that kid's head off to get him to stay on that floor. He is a little woozy right now. Saw Derek Phelps the other night at the University of North Carolina, not on exactly the same kind of play, but he took a blow and had to go out of the game and never did return.
Oh. Ah. 1:45 remaining in the half, a 7-point lead by Tech. Duke has not trailed this year at halftime. In fact, has trailed for only 18 minutes coming in out of 405 possible.
Going to occupy the clock a little bit here. Dish inside to Mackey.
Oh, right off the knee. And oh, I thought it was going to be Duke's basketball.
No, I think it's going to be overruled. I think it will be. I think it's going to be overruled. Yep. Good call.
Right off the knee of Forrest.
But Jim, if you're not looking at the scoreboard, you have a feeling right now that Georgia Tech has a commanding lead. But then you look up there, it's only 7 points. They're staying in the zone. I figure Grant Hill about the own. Grant and Thomas, the only two key scorers out there. Where are the points going to come from?
Blakeney.
I don't think Blakeney wants to take the shot.
Bark, who's nailed a three in the first half. They wanted to travel here at home.
See, Thomas and Grant, the only two guys looking to take it.
There's a three. Would have cut it to four. Meek has position. Down to five. The lead had been at one time 15 in this half.
Well, against Boston University, Meek had 21 points and 11 rebounds. He's given some solid minutes here.
Shot clock is turned off.
Pretty good overplay by the former Domatha product. He's had his career hampered with a knee injury as Blakey.
Brian Hill.
That's a push off, gets away with it.
Jumper just inside the three, and it drops. Watch out, Grant Hill knows where the clock is. Oh, they would have ruled it no good anyway. I thought he released it in time. Little does it matter. A misfire, and Georgia Tech at the half leads 44-37. Greg Gumbel will be along from New York with Prudential Securities at the half after this message and a word from your local station.
Road to the Final Four is sponsored by Pizza Hut. Sometimes you gotta stop and smell the pizza. United, come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly the friendly skies. And by AT&T, the right choice.
Well, for number one Duke, the first time the Devils have trailed at halftime this season, their 23-game win streak in jeopardy against Georgia Tech. Jim Nance and Billy Packer. And Billy, you know, this lead at one time was 15. But Travis Best did not play the final 8.5 minutes of the first half.
Well, I thought that Georgia Tech did a pretty good job without him. I mean, he was off to a blazing start in this game. As I pointed out, he had not played well against Duke last year in two of the three matchups. Was playing well today. And to lose a player of his significance as well as he was playing, I thought Georgia Tech did a pretty good job.
Best one of three players for Tech with 10 points at halftime. Let's show you some of the important stats in the first half. Field goal percentage for Duke. You can see only 8 out of 22.
And very seldom did Duke ever have a chance to go back for the second shot. And there you can see what kept them in the game. And it has been one of their trademarks and their success. Great play from the foul line.
And turnovers. Duke, by the way, in the final 12 minutes of the first half, committed only one foul.
Now here's we're going to see that play again. And Jim, I do not believe that that was a foul. I mean, contact does not necessarily mean a foul. Mackey was setting the screen. He was properly set. He took a normal screening position. Bobby Hurley had
obviously a real collision there. He's back playing right now, and I looked at him while he was shooting around at halftime. He kind of just winked over and said, I guess I'm ready to go, but he really took a blow.
That is the third against Newbill.
Well, what he did is he got underneath Antonio Lang and just tried to ride him on out. That was an easy call. You see Georgia Tech with foul trouble now. They're going to have to stay in that zone. They started out an aggressive man-to-man, then went box and one, and now primarily a zone. Best out on top. Matching up.
Parks takes the outside shot. Pretty sweet on that one. Cherokee Parks. 4 points in the game.
Jim, I'd make sure on this possession, if I were Georgia Tech, that Forrest touches the ball. Really important for them to get a good shot. There he is.
He wanted it all the way.
Yep, he sure did.
Parks with the rebound.
He tried to force that shot, but I think it was important that he touch it. He's their leading scorer. You want to get off the snide here in the start of the second half. Nice touch pass.
Grant Hill. The lead has been sliced to three. Hill has 16 now for Duke.
Is he smooth, Jimmy? Just so under control when he plays. Bobby Crimmins goes for the quick timeout here. Mike Krzyzewski like that.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Georgia Tech baseball team hosts their annual...
Number one, Duke. Number eight, Iowa. A top 10 Top Gun over-the-top interconference slam fest next Saturday on CBS Sports.
So the Hill jumper cuts it to three, and Georgia Tech, with a timeout called, now will set up for its second possession of the second half.
Key matchup here, Jim. Grant Hill in no foul trouble at all on Forrest. They set the double low screen. Travis Best trying to lose Hurley down there among all those picks.
Parks right over the back. His first.
Well, if you're Bobby Crimmins and you call that timeout, you sure hope you get something out of the set offense, and he certainly did that time. It wasn't a basket, but he picked up the foul, and his team really responded to what he talked about in the huddle. Make sure they get a good shot here.
Here it is, Best. That's a three. Bobby Hurley told me this week, Billy, I don't prefer going against smaller point guards. I'd rather go against a bigger one. I can move right past him.
Well, last year, Best in one game was 0 for 3 against Duke. The other game, 2 for 8. He's hot here today. Hurley goes to draw the charge on Mackey. Did I say he was tough? Or did, can you imagine that? With the blow that he took in the first half, he was going to stand there and hold his ground against 6'10", 245, Malcolm Mackey.
Georgia Tech.
Duke goes to a similar set, double low post. Oh, Daniel tried to reverse it in the air.
Got stuck really underneath the backboard. Off of Georgia Tech.
That was a little bit of a la Michael Jordan there, where you just go up in the air and guys that are that gifted just create a shot. Solid screen by Lang.
And Lang gets it.
Protected.
Thomas Hill up high. High arcing shot.
Yep, he changed the arc on the shot knowing it was going to get blocked, and obviously has worked hard on that particular play to be able to know what kind of trajectory he needed.
Three-pointer, Brian Hill.
Well, we talked about Brian being on a tear since he got those starting assignments.
Parks, too strong. Mackey gets the quick outlet.
Look at Forrest.
Hurley trying to draw, he dies. They call it against Georgia Tech's Travis Best, his third.
Did not like that call, Jim.
Travis Best has been picking up a lot of fouls. I mean, Bobby Hurley with a big acting job there. But Best has to be aware that he's been getting in foul trouble and just maybe could have pulled that up and give it to Forrest as a trailer.
Been getting in foul trouble for reaching in a lot this season, but that one called on the charge. Antonio Lang. That's outside, way outside for Lang. Hill on the follow. Still fighting for it.
Oh, how about that move?
And Moore with the rebound. Great effort by Grant Hill, but doesn't get the basket.
Grant's been a lot more assertive in this game offensively.
James Forrest dishes underneath to Mackey. From the league's top score to the league's top rebounder.
Build it back up to nine.
There's Moore again. He is playing. Now, he doesn't have a lot of points, but he is playing a great game here.
Look at Best. Duke had its back turned, and Forrest slammed up.
Georgia Tech showing some moxie here, Jim. They're playing hard-nosed basketball.
And another big three by Hurley to quiet him. Only for a moment, though, because they had Forrest up ahead. He'll shoot two.
You know, Jim, if you're playing against Duke, one of the things you have to be cognizant of is that at big play time, Bobby Hurley has throughout his career hit those big three-point shots, and I think you've just got to go find him. He almost never misses when that game kind of situation's on the line.
You see Grant Hill the weekend after winning the national championship at the Metrodome. Grant Hill and Antonio Lang came to Atlanta to pay visit to Travis Best and James Forrest. A little get-together for the four of them. They went to the McDonald's High School All-America game right here. And they also went to an MC Hammer contest. Forrest told me on the phone also that he speaks with Grant Hill at least once a week.
Well, two players that are on these teams played in that game. Marquise Moore, obviously, from Georgia Tech, who has gotten in today. And on the other side of the ledger, Chris Collins, who has not yet gotten in for Duke.
This is only now the third free throw. Flat tip for Tech.
Now you've got to see if Hurley can get off stride with his dribbling.
Clark steps in to nail it too. He has seven.
Second big shot he made. Hit that three-pointer in the first half. Hardy played very well for Duke over in Maui.
It was like 10 out of 12 shots over in Maui.
Tough man-to-man by Duke.
Mackey at the last second gives it up to Best. He is smooth.
He really is.
15 for Travis Best. Stolen away by Tech. And a foul on Duke. Actually, no foul. They say that.
I think he had his hands on the ball, but Clark's one foot was out of bounds.
Right, exactly. Standing on the baseline. Best, who has made 6 out of 8 from the floor.
And again, he's wisely giving up the ball, then coming back to meet it in offensive scoring position.
Here's one called on Duke. Marty Clark with the push-off, his first. Third team foul on the Devils in the second half, and the Dolphins 14-0 over San Diego. Does it surprise you Duke's longest all-time win streak is 23? I thought it might be a little bit longer.
Well, one of the things, Jim, in the real top leagues, you have a hard time running on long winning streaks because you're going to have to play good people every night.
What a block by Hill. Hurley. Thomas Hill trying to keep it alive, and it gets to Brian Hill, a 3-on-2.
Oh, Grant Hill, what a play.
And almost saved it, but he was out of bounds.
Here we see Hill going down, probably trying to do a little bit too much here. Glided to the side, and then look at Grant Hill go after that ball. How about this little zone by Duke?
They want to change it up. Tech is 5 for 7 from the floor in this half.
Duke is picking up some fouls. Duke playing a little matchup of their own.
Shooting over 60% for the game, Georgia Tech.
Travis Best trying to get loose.
There's a turnover.
Well, I credit that one to Mike Krzyzewski. Changed up his defense. Georgia Tech really never got settled.
What did Brian Hill give Martise Moore a dirty look?
Now he's been telling everybody to come meet the ball.
Foul on Marty Clark on the back of Forrest. His second team foul, number 4.
Hey, Jim, I saw something there on that particular defense, the matchup, that could really work in Duke's favor. They're matching up with a 2-3 zone out front, and that time Bobby Hurley swung wide and took Best with him, which led a one-on-one situation for Grant Hill all alone.
With his Brian Hill.
Yes, and it'll give him an opportunity to get a lot of easy shots, even though his opponent's in his zone.
So Drew Berry comes in for the first time in the second half, replacing Moore. Berry, number 10. That's wide open after some screening. But Meek pulls it down for Duke. Hill, slam time.
Now Bobby Hurley, probably still a little woozy, but still can put that ball on the floor, can't he?
22nd dunk of the year for Grant Hill.
Oh.
Hurley, 3-on-1. Oh, nice tap by Grant Hill.
And Bobby Hurley, it was amazing. I was watching his eyes on that defensive play, Jim, and he was watching Best and saying, you know, I'm going to pick this thing off. Again, I think it'd be wise for Best to keep running Hurley down low under the screens and not handling it out up top.
Georgia Tech's lead has been narrowed to 5. Under 12 minutes remaining.
Turnaround jumper.
Forrest, short, Meek. Pulled out a couple of rebounds in the last minute. Hurley, another pull-up 3. Might be on Thomas Hill. Yes, they flagged Thomas Hill for his 3rd. And an official's timeout under 12 minutes. 57-52. Number 10 Tech over number 1 Duke.
Today,
Georgia Tech, look at the field goal percentage, Edge, and the points in the paint. But in fact, 57-52, Georgia Tech. Jim Nance and Billy Packer from Alexander Memorial Coliseum. 10,125 today, a new all-time attendance record. This building that first opened in 1956.
Duke University opened it.
Duke beat them.
Yep.
First game ever played here. Beat them 71-61.
And of course, Georgia Tech broke an all-time record for attendance in the state of Georgia with the game they played recently in the Georgia Dome.
Buzzer beater by Forrest against Louisville. 28,000 they had at the Georgia Dome.
Right. Which will be the site of Olympic basketball here in a few years.
And in contention for a future Final Four.
And this will be the Final Four city for the women this year in the NCAA. So Atlanta's moving.
Oh, this is against Thomas
hand
Hill.
Check, yeah, hand
oh,
check.
That's number 4. 4th on Thomas Hill.
And Tony Lang coming in for him right away. Thomas Hill asking to stay, but there's a lot of time in this game, so he's got to yank him. Now this really cuts down on the opportunity to surround that zone and puts a lot of pressure on Marty Clark to become a scorer.
Perry at the last second gets it to Mackey.
Creep out of the zone, back to their man-to-man. Well, Best is rubbing off those screens when he goes down low, trying to shake Hurley loose.
Well, that's a move you used to see Rick make all the time. Now, Travis. Rebound by Grant. Hill. Nearing the 10-minute mark to go. 5-point Tech lead.
Well, Georgia Tech didn't score there, but that was very good offensive movement.
Easy basket. And Hill with 20. 3-point game.
You know, Jim, this is the most assertive I've ever seen Grant Hill, kind of like Leighton used to do last year. Hey, guys, he's talking to people out there. He's egging them on, getting the big boards.
Nice drive by Barry. I see that, Billy, too. It's a different story from a year ago, that's for sure.
It really is. I mean, he wants the ball. He's going for the rebound.
There
he's
is again.
Over. Yep.
And he walks right, marches right back to the free throw line.
And he's just taken over now. Bloodline starting to flow here.
Let's line up your Saturday for you. The lineup starts off at 2 Eastern time with the NCAA Division I Men's Soccer Championship, followed at 3 Eastern with the ActiFed Ski Cup from Heavenly Valley, California. Then at 4, Billy will be at Cameron Indoor Stadium in Durham, North Carolina for another top 10 showdown. Iowa against Duke, although Iowa will drop out of the top 10 in the new poll tomorrow. Iowa having lost twice this week, unbeaten entering the week.
Kind of interesting talk about that soccer Final Four. Duke was in it.
Duke and Virginia.
Davidson.
And San Diego State. And Duke has a player from the soccer team now dressed in basketball uniform, Stan Brunson.
I think one of the great things there for people that maybe not follow intercollegiate soccer is that Davidson got in the Final Four without one player on scholarship. A walk-on team.
Barry.
There's Hurley.
Hurley sees Clark coming from the other wing, gets it to him. Tough shot. But a block called on Tech. Called on Best.
Well, there wasn't much that Marty Clark could do, because it was a tough shot. Travis would have been wide just to stay away from him. That's his fourth, Jim.
Balance on Travis Best. That's his fourth.
Now, what Travis has got to do is sometimes that, you know, the hustle is good, but you have to use your head a little bit. I mean, knowing he has three and can't sit down, he's got to let Clark take that shot.
Clark
would have been a tough one to make.
Made his first 16 free throws of the season. We'll shoot two.
Oh, that's a shooter's roll there.
I think the biggest thing he has accomplished so far in his career, halfway through his career at Duke, coming in the final 2 minutes against Indiana last year at the Final Four and nailing 5 out of 6 from the free throw line.
No question about it, Jim. Everybody talked about the great three-point shooting for Indiana's comeback, but had he not made those free throws, those would have been winning shots as opposed to those that just got it close.
1-point game with 9:39 to go.
Duke extends their defense, looking for some trapping. Now Best has to be really careful offensively, too, because a charge is something you can pick up very easily here.
Well, they take it away. Clark steals it from Mackey. Hurley wants to split the defenders, gives it up to Hill. No call, and Duke has taken the lead for the first time today.
Bobby Crimmins has to go for his second timeout. Now that really hurts, because remember that quick one he had to call at the start of the second half.
It was 1:13 away from an official's timeout. Duke in front by 1.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by Oldsmobile, official car for NCAA championships. Intel, the computer inside. And by Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
How about this eyewitness, Don Nelson, Golden State. He's here.
One of the most brilliant minds in basketball. He's here with his son today. He was coached in the Olympics this summer.
His son did?
Yep.
12-2 run for Duke to take the lead. trailing by as many as 15 in the first half.
Travis Best pulled up a little bit lame. I don't know what happened to him there.
Moore with a three. He's been quiet offensively, but he drills the three-pointer to give Tech the two-point lead. His first points.
We're getting that 2-3 matchup zone. Now, nice to see if Grant Hill realizes what they do when he touches the ball there.
Clean stuff by Forrest. Right back to Parks.
Oh, what a play by Parks.
And what a play by Lang to save it and feed it right back into Parks.
You know, if it hadn't been for Lang, that Oklahoma game might have gone the other way. He came up so big at the end with a power move inside and played well in that overtime.
Mike Krzyzewski said we need Lang to get back to the way he was playing at the end of last year when he started the last 18 games.
He's a solid factor in the NCAA tournament for him.
Been hampered by a fracture, hairline fracture in the sinus area. And now trying to get back to 100%.
Seems like Best really concerned about that four fouls. He's not putting the ball on the floor and penetrating like he was before.
Mackey walk. Under 10 on the shot clock. Too strong, and Parks with the rebound.
Now Travis Best, if he's going to be out there, Jim, he's got to go ahead offensively and not be afraid to put the ball on the floor. Duke going to use a little clock here, take a rest. Has been an Iron Man 5 out there.
Hurley, three-pointer.
Now,
foul was called away from the shot.
It's going to be Forrest pushing Clark down.
It's going to be the third on Forrest. And the fifth team foul against Georgia Tech.
Actually, you get a little tired, Jim, and instead of getting out there with your feet, you just push, use your hands.
That's his third.
I don't believe Forrest has been out of this game today either. He and Grant Hill have been Iron Men. Bobby Kerman's trying to get the zone more active.
Well, they passed it right around and found a wide open Grant Hill, now with 26. Duke by two.
Haven't been able to get the ball to Forrest down low because Lang's playing in front of him. He's got to get some screens on the baseline to get the ball on a swing.
Moore. Well, he just made his first basket of the game with a three. Now he adds a two off the glass to tie it.
Good-looking young player, isn't he?
Going to be a great one. They seem to every year have one outstanding newcomer at Georgia Tech. They had a long streak going there.
He had six ACC rookies of the year.
Hurley with the three.
Lang keeps it alive.
Comes to Brian Hill. They have the numbers. He goes to Best.
Smart.
Didn't want to go inside with that fourth foul, did he, Billy?
He pulled up to take the jumper, and when he got in the air, he changed his mind and looked for the lob for Mackey. But he did the smart thing, pulling up and not going to the hoops. But the shot was his to have. Watch, he goes up for the shot, then realizes at the last minute that Mackey's covered. Instead of, it's not a shot and it's not a lob. It's caught halfway.
Tie game, 6:05 remaining. 64-64. Timeout called by Duke. Duke has two timeouts left, Georgia Tech with one. The arrow belongs to the Jackets. Here's a note for you Duke followers. Duke has won the last three times it has trailed at the half. That was against Michigan in the title game, Indiana in the semis against UNLV in 91. They came back to win all of them. Here's a steal, however, by Drew Berry. Dribbling right past the Duke team and putting Tech in front.
And you know who he beat at half court? Bobby Hurley on the dribble. You don't see that often. Hurley just reached out, and Tech goes back to man-to-man. Nice move by Bobby Crimmins, changing his defense when he figured Mike Krzyzewski was setting something up against his own.
Best almost got the steal.
Now, if you're Best, what do you have to think of right now? Don't let Hurley shoot a three.
Hurley, that's a two. A two. To tie it at 66.
a two by a half a foot.
13 points for Hurley.
Because he's going to take that shot on that occasion. You got to force him to put the ball on the floor.
Mackey had the position on Parks and rattles it home.
Good post feeding by Barry.
Great atmosphere.
And Moore not going for any fakes by Thomas Hill.
Hill. Parks.
Oh,
ripped away by Barry. Took it right out of his hands. The long bounce pass. Moore gives it up. Forrest tries to set up inside Mackey. And a foul, a push off against Parks.
Now, Jim, sometimes you think players make one pass too many. Georgia Tech dodged the bullet there. You see Parks goes up strong, has a nice rebounding position, and then Barry just rips it away from him. One of four brothers to play Division I college basketball. That's got to be some kind of record.
Parks sits with two. That puts Duke to the number of 17 fouls, so a 1-1. Duke has attempted 24 more free throws than Georgia Tech today. Tech is 2 out of 3 from the line. Here's a 1-1.
Young man here working on his 6th double-double of the year.
He has 7 rebounds, averaging 11 rebounds. People forget all the way back to that Final Four team, Malcolm Mackey was the leading rebounder on that team his freshman year.
They come out with aggressive man-to-man here. Good switch by Barry. Hurley may want to try to take him one-on-one here. Not a good shot.
I think Barry got a hand on it. Clark saves it, but right out to Barry. So Georgia Tech has the basketball with a 4-point lead under 4 minutes to go.
Boy, Barry's come up with some big plays, Jim. 3 in a row. Excellent pass, 2 steals. A layup.
Gave it up instead. Moore missed the easy one.
Forrest. Two outstanding players.
Thomas Hill blocked by Moore, saved by Best.
And these freshmen are putting on a show defensively.
Barry again.
And offensively.
Bobby Crimmins, there's the assist by Forrest. Crimmins said, this kid's come in and won 3 games for us this year. Talking about Drew Barry. Thomas Hill short.
Yep, Moore again with a hand in his face.
Grant Hill trying to save it out of bounds.
And Jim, we talked about all of breaking all of these streaks. Duke, you talked about having an opportunity to set their all-time streak. And, of course, the greatest streak of all time, Georgia Tech eliminated.
Kentucky.
In 1955, with 129 straight, Kentucky had won at home. Georgia Tech was in there, played the game with just 5 players. Team with a losing record in the SEC that year with 2 of their wins against Kentucky.
And a timeout. Duke is left with 1. Each team has 1 timeout. Hurley's 3 cuts it to 5. Only 3 undefeated teams in Division I-A basketball, and one of them in trouble.
You got to ask the question here, Jim.
What is that, a question
that
mark?
That was supposed to be a question mark.
One of the all-time worst question marks ever drawn.
Well, you know why? Because I never go ahead and count any chickens before they hatch in regard to what way Duke plays. But
again, another freshman scores again.
Moore, and it's a 7-point lead.
Moore and Barry have been unlucky.
What a shot by Grant Hill. And he ties his
career high. Tries to go for a steal. Puts the referee down. Of course, the fans applauding, figuring that Duke was on the foul line a little bit too many times. Barry telling the referee, he's doing everything out of here. He's telling the referees to clean up a spot on the floor. But, you know, Moore defensively and Barry defensively, and then on the other end of the floor, have really picked up the slack. Best has been quieted down with those fouls. They haven't been able to get the ball to Forrest.
Oh, look at Moore break free, but he's led too much. Hey, and they get to, well, they say he touched it before it went out, so they'll go the length of the court in even 2 minutes remaining. I didn't think any touched it.
Yeah, it is his foot.
Okay, well, the clock never changed.
Well, Jim, one of the things there, Barry took a calculated gamble, 5-point lead, that's just two possessions. Might have been better to hang on the ball and use some clock. Blocked.
Nope, foul call.
Gonna call, said he got him on a hand.
Forrest called for his fourth. Sixth team foul, but this was a shooting situation. Grant Hill will go to the line looking for a career high. He's already matched it with 28.
Jim, you know what's interesting? You talk to Mike Krzyzewski, you know, when Grant was a freshman, and he'd say, you know, he may be the best thing that we've got, and we never really saw it in terms of taking over a game like he's doing right now. But obviously that man knows his basketball. He sure wasn't far from wrong.
12 for 12 from the line today. And he has a new career high. And it's the most points scored against Tech this year. Mashburn and Rhodes of Kentucky had scored 27. In Kentucky's win, Tech's only loss of the year, in fact, to number 2 Kentucky. One more for Hill. Long. First miss of the day. 14 tries.
Somebody should be wide open.
Right back to Barry.
That was Grant Hill that got a piece of that ball.
Thomas Hill. Bounces right back to him. Grant Hill. Hey, he never shoots threes, Billy.
Marty Clark should have kept that alive on the boards and doesn't.
Duke has trimmed it to 2 with 1:15 remaining.
Remember that timeout situation, Bobby Crean, is that one he called right at the beginning of the half. He'd like to have one now. There he takes it. That wipes him out of timeouts.
So Tech is out of timeouts. Duke has one remaining. 1:04 on the game clock. Tech by 2. Jim Nance and Billy Packer with Georgia Tech in possession. No timeouts for the Jackets, who scored the game's first 12 points. Now they cling to a 76-74 lead. Boy, you talk about a team that has specialized in buzzer-winning performances. I think Crimmins has had 13 of them since 1984.
Well, we think of that Michigan State, Georgia Tech game, Kenny Anderson game. Of course, James Forrest has been involved in 3 of those that he's personally put in the win column.
The miracle in Milwaukee, another one last year, this year against Louisville.
That was funny that Mackey's only 2 threes he's ever made were winning
Forrest.
Shots.
Forrest, yeah.
That'd be Forrest, yeah.
And we saw Grant Hill take a 3-point shot. Again, he only made one his
right
whole career.
His career.
Best brings it back out. What a possession this is. 2-point lead, 48 seconds remaining.
Forrest down low for the turnaround jumper on Grant Hill.
Oh, Hill. He's going to be called for it, even though he ended up with the basketball.
Well, a good set play by Bobby Crimmins. Guy's leading the ACC in scoring. You know he's a good power post player. That, you know, it shows you what a good job Lang was doing on Forrest, because Forrest just couldn't touch the ball in the low post while Lang was on him, and Grant Hill played behind him.
Forrest has 13 points. He has a streak coming into this game of 8 in a row with at least 20.
James Forrest at the line shooting
told me that the coach Crimmins told him coming into the year, you're a sophomore, but you got to play as a junior or a senior if we want to make a run at the Final Four. He'll shoot one more.
Travis Best doing the mumbo jumbo out there with his feet, just trying to wish that one would go back in.
It's at the three, 77-74.
Shot clock out. Good job by Mackey on that solid screen.
Does Bobby have another memorable three in his bag of tricks?
Well, they know who they want to get it to, and they're trying to keep it away from him. See, he's trying to get the three. I think he's waiting too long here, Jim.
20 seconds to go. There it is. Short all the way. Rebound by Hill. It's a three. Over the backboard, it belongs to Tech with 12 seconds. 12 seconds remaining.
Jim, they had 40 seconds on the clock. There was plenty of time to go for a two, get the ball back in another possession. I'm really surprised Bobby Hurley, with everybody knowing what he was going to try to do, kept the ball in his possession that long.
Foul right away.
That's why I think you go for the two. You have the ability to stop the clock with the foul.
It'll be a one-and-one situation for Malcolm Mackey. 61% free throw shooter.
Now with 12 seconds, Jim, you get down in the situation, down three. You've got to be looking for the three-point shot. But they had 40 seconds to go. Plenty of time to go inside to a Grand Hill, get something solid. Dom Georgia Tech might think about pressing Duke right here to occupy as much time as possible for him, bringing it up the court, so even if they get a shot off, they can waste 6-7 seconds.
1-1 for Mackey. Oh, it'll take two possessions.
See, here's where you jump right into a press. Force Duke to take up 4 or 5 seconds. You make sure nobody fouls because you don't want to stop this clock at all.
5-point lead.
Did they pick up the press? Good job by Best.
Hurley foot on the line. That's only a two. He had a toe right on the line.
Really didn't make that much difference, Jim. Two or three. They got to get another three anyway. Down three. Now here's the situation. Does Georgia Tech have the nerve to go long on this pass? Because Duke is going to be playing to get this inbounds pass. Tech has been looking long all day long. Up three. Would you rather go long and take the chance to get the easy two, or do you want it inbounds and let Duke foul you?
Well, they've already turned it over once in the last 2 minutes going long. I'd just soon see them. If I was Tech, just throw it inbounds.
You
now
can
look
see,
at, watch the foot.
Tried to back up, but no question is both feet were actually on the line. Boy, it's been a gutty performance. A lot of people don't remember what happened to him in the first half when he was leveled to the ground on what I thought was a clean screen by Mackey.
I'll say this, Billy. It's only January the 10th, but with that firepower inside of Georgia Tech, James Forrest and Malcolm Mackey and Travis Best at the point and Barry coming off the bench, this is a serious contender for a run at the Final Four.
I would agree that the young players that they have coming off the bench are playing with enthusiasm, a nice blend of experience and youth. If they can keep Travis Best out of foul trouble, remember he only played 12 minutes in the first half and was playing very well. I think if I'm Georgia Tech, I take one good look at a man going long. There goes Forrest. They get it inside. He got a foul.
5 seconds on the clock. Mackey will go back to the line. Still in the 1-1.
Well, Jim, if he makes this one, they cannot lose the game. Because with 5 seconds, you don't have to take the ball out of bounds. and you just stand there and hold the ball and don't put it back in play, there'd be no way that Duke could score again.
Well, Duke, having used its last timeout, should he miss, they cannot stop it.
And here is one of the instances, and I wonder sometimes why coaches do it, but to keep the guys off the line, but you sure don't want some kind of accidental foul, but Georgia Tech puts everybody on the line.
So a 1-1 with 5 seconds to go. Mackey's 4-for-4 today. Oh, they were in the double bonus. I stand corrected.
Now that's not all bad, Jim.
So he's got one more.
Even if he misses one here, it's going to take a couple of seconds to go ahead and get the ball in possession.
So that was the 10th. We had him for 9. That was the 10th. That puts it
in four. Game's over.
Yep. Tech doesn't even have to D it up. Parks 3 makes it a 1-point final. The Duke winning streak is over at 23. Number one Duke defeated by Georgia Tech 80-79. The Chevrolet players of the game are Grant Hill of Duke with a career high 29 and Drew Berry of Georgia Tech with 11 points, 4 steals and some big plays down the stretch. Checking the amount of $1,000 donated to each college's general scholarship fund. So for Billy Packer, Jim Nance saying so long from Atlanta, where the final score is Georgia Tech 80, Duke 79. Kentucky will be the nation's new number one ranked team. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports, home of the NCAA Basketball Championship.